let me get there because I gotta catch the second half. One second. Ain't nobody say reset.
Reset.
Listen, if you can hear me say amen, I want you to understand, you can stop today. See, some things happened over the last week in my life that I'll never be the same again.
Come on, Apostle. Yes.
What God will do, Melinda, he'll give you a revelation that tests you on it.
Yes.
And if you don't understand it as a test, you will think something went wrong. But every time you receive a word of a promotion, he's going to test you after the word.
Come on,
son. See, a lot of times you preach that he's testing you before the word.
Yes.
He prepares you before the word.
Right.
But once you release it, you receive it in the spirit. When you step out of your house, the test is waiting for you.
Oh, yes.
So now you got a choice to make. Did I believe it? Or am I go back to my flesh?
Oh, my God.
I was like, come on, can I help you all just a little bit?
Yes.
You are some powerful people.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. You are some powerful people.
Yes, Lord.
But what you have to do is believe.
That's true.
You have to have confidence in God. You have to be able to trust God. Amen. See, when you speak this thing out of you, you have to be declaring knowing.
Right. Yes. Understand. Come on, Apostle. Yes.
God, help me get all this right here this morning. I feel Jesus. I need the two people who have any kind of firmly put your hand on yourself. God, just release your healing. Oh, I don't believe it. I need two people. If you struggle with any kind of firmly, put your hand on it. You could have received my healing, been released from my apostle. He just healed you. I feel the Holy Ghost here. Ouch! I feel the Holy Ghost here. So he has to be here. Ouch! Son, that about Holy and your sky. Borat. See, the Bible says the spirit of a man sustains his infirmity. Your flesh can get sick, but your spirit can't. Oh God, I'm still young preaching. If you understand who you are, what I'm doing in my life today for that, no matter what I'm dealing with, can I testify? You know, I've been under some serious attacks. What's going on? I had a big old lump on my shoulder here, you know. And, and this morning, my neck was stiff, and I said, you know what? From my belly, somebody's in this to Christ right here. Get somebody to believe this. Just the Christ right here.
Yes.
It's right here.
Yes.
You don't gotta look up to heaven. He's right here.
Come on.
And from this right here, you can release this thing into every part of your body and out before you if you want to.
Yes.
And I said, from my belly, I released that healing through my arms and down through my fingers. And I'm going to take my fingers and put it on this lump. And I'm going to declare in the name of Jesus has to disappear. Y'all ain't talking back to me. So I have any believers in here? I want you to make a decision right now. Whatever it is, you can speak your prosperity.
In the name of Jesus.
You know, I've been declaring money because I ain't going there because I'm going to be reset. And sometimes people don't give a church like they should. Somebody say that. So I'm going to be declaring money.
Right. Yes.
And my wife don't want me to say this.
Reset.
I ain't giving y'all nothing. Somebody say that. But I have some money just come.
Reset. My Lord, reset.
But out of my belly.
Jesus.
I ain't giving none either, Michelle. Out of my belly. Y'all know what would be here. I was facing some things, Josh. And before I go around calling people to ask them for money, or before I come to church trying to make you feel guilty, I go to Christ in me. I go to Christ in me. And I release. Because God promised me he'd give me an abundance of money. He said that before I started the church. So I began to release that money.
Come on, sir.
And then you get a text that you wouldn't expect. Glory. All you can do is give God the glory.
Yes.
And give God the praise. Because, Why did I get some of y'all? I feel jealous spirits. So anyway.
Get your mango.
I feel somebody getting jealous. Somebody's in it. So. Here's what I'm going to close with. Because I'm going to deal with it. With the faith and patience stuff, because that's what I came to preach this morning, but God turned me around this morning. I want you to understand, your words are the keys to the kingdom. Yes. Now stop and hear me, please. I will play them. Your words are the keys to the kingdom in you.
That's right.
I have no control over the kingdom in her except to feed her. Yes. And give her the word. Yes. Because when you receive the word and you understand it, it's confirming something in the Christ. And your words, that's why the enemy put pressure on you to talk foolishness. That's why he pressed you to talk against your spouse and your mates. That's why he pressed you to talk against your children. And some of you are against your pastor. Don't say amen.
Amen.
I need to go down the hall and somebody heard. The rest of y'all lying, but y'all talking to me too. Somebody say amen. Now watch this. Watch this. But the things, I feel the Holy Ghost. Anybody feel the Spirit of God in here? The things that pertaining to your kingdom is in the Christ in you. But now we are being taught the only way to get out is speaking. The only way to get something out of your spiritual mouth is to speak it. And the test comes when it don't look like what you heard.
Yes.
Say it.
Can you still speak the house when they put you out of the apartment?
Yes, Lord.
My God.
Can you still speak the healing that God promised you when the doctor said that works? I'm God preaching here. I feel the Holy Ghost. Can you preach the relationship and declare it? It's a word, it's a godly relationship, a mouthpiece, a sign for God, when it looks like y'all getting ready to split up.
My Lord Jesus.
Can you declare a hard relationship when you can't stand them for that 5 minutes?
5 months.
My Lord.
Yeah, hey, man. I think it is. Sometimes a little bit longer than that. Somebody say amen to that. But can you agree? God help me. Josh, I'm a big preacher. Can you? I feel you. I love y'all. Can you agree with God in spite of what you see?
Yes, Lord.
Gentlemen, watch your mouth in this season.
Instructions.
You have been promoted. You have come on, you've been promoted. Watch your mouth.
My Lord.
I believe Solomon said, you should be snared by the words of your mouth. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for bringing it up.
Yes.
You need your word to trap you.
Come on, sir.
Your word to put you in prison.
Yes.
And you must say something. It's just who I am. Sure, that's just how you are. That's why your life is a mess.
Yeah. Needs instructions.
Hallelujah.
I need everybody to begin to pray in the spirit for me, world. Give me some music, please. I need you, if you have the gift of tongues, I need you to pray in the spirit for me. Yes, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Borean Dios y canta la voz por ahí. Y canta la voz por ahí. All right, I need everybody praying. Just trust the Spirit of the Lord. If you don't have prayer tongues, just pray in English. Amen. I'm gonna leave up for 5 minutes. Come on, I need you to pray. I need you to pray. Cut the music up for me, please. I need the sanctuary to pray. Something is about to happen. I need the sanctuary to pray. I need you to pray. I need you to come out of yourself and open your mouth and pray. Oh, Rabasi Kande, Rosheke. Rabasi Kanda, Roskuri. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, I need everybody praying. All right, something is about to happen. Something is about to break through. Glory to God, it's about to break. Something is about to happen.